Good morning to all my friends and family, and welcome to this episode of Jim's 5am Club. Happy Friday to all on this most magnificent spring Sydney morning. We've got the sunrise happening over there in the east. You can just see the early beautiful rays of the sun as it's rising over there on the Tasman Sea. I'm up here on my way to Observatory Hill. And as you can see, we've got the Harbour Bridge, we've got morning traffic, and the flags fluttering with a gentle breeze from the southeast is what it appears to be. Anyway, what I'll do today, as I normally do on Jim's 5am Club, is we'll go on a walk and talk and go through yet another book summary. And I'm proud to say that after a good 2 years that I'm now in a position to be able to say that I'm one of the most prolific bloggers throughout the world on personal development material, with close to 1,500 books or 1,500 episodes of my Jim's 5am Club that I've been able to film, produce from different places throughout Sydney, throughout New South Wales, and hopefully throughout the world as I get to travel a little bit more. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to walk around to the other side of Observatory Hill. As you can see here, we have the observatory. It's a modest setup, but something which is quite historic and quite significant for each and every one of us to be appreciative of and to be proud of. Anyway, so what I'm going to do today is go through a book, a very interesting book entitled Love Warrior by an author named Glennon, Doyle, Melton. And it's a pretty powerful book, a pretty profound book, which goes through some interesting and very, very deep concepts on love, on existence, that I guess many of us can resonate with. And hopefully we can take a few morsels from this book, a few lessons, a few life hacks, and use it in our lives, and hopefully become shining beacons, great examples to others, and help them get through the challenges and struggles in their lives. This book touches on reality. It doesn't sugarcoat things. And I guess what it does is it helps us all to realize that we're not alone in our struggles, in our challenges. And I'm just entering the rotunda here at Observatory Hill. And this area here is often used for people with their proposals. And as you can see, you've got the floral petals on the floor. And there is a magnificent view of the Harbour Bridge and the surrounds from this area. What I've also noticed is it's lavender time, with the jacarandas in full blossom, and it's a beautiful, most beautiful time of year, and especially from places like this, where you can look across the rocks, the oldest part of Sydney, across to North Sydney, and we can just do a 360 from this location, and you can see this is a brilliant picnic area, a place where you can bring your family, your children, your friends, and spend an afternoon, spend a lunchtime having a picnic on the beautiful manicured grass areas up here. So without a further ado, let's kick off for this book summary and see where it leads us, see what we can learn, and see how we can incorporate it in our thinking, in our worldview. The author kicks off this book summary with a beautiful message, with a great call to action, where she says that the only meaningful thing that we can offer one another is love. Not advice, not questions about our choices, not suggestions for the future, just love. So leading on from that entry message, the author goes on to say with her first formal point that there are people out there who understand you and share your struggles. So don't ever think that we are or you are alone. Like everyone else, we are all looking to fit in somewhere, to belong, to be part of a family, a team, a community. For that is how we are wired. We have always been like that. We have always been social beings, according to this author, and I guess nobody can argue with that. And the author then goes on to say that this craving to belong, this craving to fit in, can cause issues to some people, especially in those formative years when people are growing up and people are going through those awkward stages in their lives. And the author here talks about the challenges that she faced in those early years with bulimia and alcohol. You know, she'd have bulimia in order to, you know, shed the weight and to look the part, to fit in. And she'd also indulge in alcohol, overindulge in alcohol, so that she could be the fun at the party. And these things, these challenges, these issues, the go-to for many adults and teens, and it was her go-to. It was her safety blanket. It was her hiding place where she would, go through these practices in order to cope, to fit in, and to try and be popular, I guess, is another way of seeing it. You see these days that people get caught up in narratives, in political movements, not because they believe it. It's because they do it in order to fit in with the other parents at the dinner party, to fit in with their friends, to do something which is considered cool, not necessarily, as we said, because they believe it, but because they have to do it in order to be accepted by the others or the influencers within a particular group. And with the advent of social media and instant messaging, this sort of behavior is being amplified, where you've got lots of people doing, saying, and following agendas and practices and political sort of ideas in order to fit in and not to be ostracized and forced to be on the outer, which is pretty sad because the world is a cruel place, and if you do voice your opinion, your conservative views, whatever they are, there is the fear that you'll be shut out, pushed to the side and ostracised. So the author then goes on to say that these hiding places, these challenges that we face, are often there for people to hide their problems. And the author makes a really valid point here, that a lot of people often try to hide their problems under basic pretexts and go on with their daily lives. But what happens is that sooner or later, everybody needs to wake up and everybody really needs to express who they authentically and really are. Otherwise, they could be guilty of living a lie and being a fake. So one day this author needed to confront her problems, as they were not going away on their own. So unless you do something to sort your life out, your life isn't going to get sorted out. It's actually going to continue along its merry way, and you're going to not only have the problems that you had, but you're going to add to those problems by not dealing with the other problems. The author then goes on to say that life will keep on serving you hard lessons until you finally listen to your inner voice. That inner voice. What is that inner voice? That inner voice is your conscience. That inner voice is your soul, your spirit. That inner voice could be your guardian angel. It could be God, and it could be something else, depending on what your beliefs are and what your religion is. But interestingly enough, and I remember hearing this at an Anthony Robbins seminar years ago, where he gets to deal with lots of people with significant problems. He says that sometimes people need to hit rock bottom in order to wake up and to propel them and to force them to take real and immediate action. And this author was married, and she found out that her husband had been cheating on her through her 3 pregnancies. And she decided from that point on to try and sort her life out. So she listened to her inner voice and stopped being a people pleaser and stopped silencing her problems. And she went on a path to discover her true calling. What I'll do is I'll start heading to work, so I'll leave the rotunda and walk through this beautiful park and continue the book summary and see what other lesson, what other life hack we have. So it's sad, but it's real that, as we said, people have challenges. We all have challenges, and those challenges need to be addressed. Because if they're not addressed, they will continue to haunt us and continue to challenge us, our children, our friends, and everybody. As we said before, don't think you're alone. Everybody has challenges and problems. And as we say, it's important to focus on, to make a decision, sort them out, to think about them, to contemplate, to reflect. Look at this magnificent tree. Just love coming up here, just seeing these old Moreton Bay figs. Just truly, truly magnificent. So the next point that the author makes on her journey to discovery, on her journey to fulfilling and living her calling, is that she realized and she learnt that it's important to know and accept that pain is the purest form of authenticity and self-love. So you need to know and accept your pain. You need to accept and embrace your problems. You need to acknowledge that you have a challenge, that you have a problem, before you can even start to work on it, to sort it out. So what I love being up here is you can just see the hive of activity around Sydney. There we have an ocean liner looking to take off on this beautiful, beautiful Sydney spring morning, as we said before, just glorious up here. So acknowledging our problems is, as we said, one of the first ways and the only ways of sorting them out. You need to identify it, you need to see it, smell it, feel it, taste it. Because problems and challenges, suffering, all of those things are part of life. And it's the currency that we need to trade. It's the currency we need to bank. It's the currency that we need to transact with in order to live a more fulfilled and purposeful life. You need to go through these challenges in order to realize and to experience the salt and pepper of life. You know, life can't be just sugar, sugar, sugar all the time. You know, we need the different colors, we need the different shades. We need to experience pain and suffering in order to experience happiness and joy and fulfillment. We need to solve problems, because problems, as we said before, are not going to solve themselves on their own. Admittedly, some will. Some problems will just go away. But many of the problems that haunt us, that have come from childhood trauma, as many psychologists talk about, are things that need to be addressed and sorted out. Else, they'll just colour our world, shade our world, and be a cloud in our skies. But we're called to try and sort them out, to remove those clouds, and to allow the rainbows of our lives to shine brightly and to colour our futures. So we need pain, and pain is a part of life, and it's a currency we need to transact with and to grow through, and to understand and to that we are all work in progress. We're not perfect. Nobody's perfect. We are all growing and developing through this world, and we are work in progress. Not perfect, as we said, but progressing to better. And we need to take steps along the way to improve where possible, to get us to where we want to go. Because acceptance, from what this author is saying, is liberation. It's very liberating to accept that you have challenges, rather than just turn your back or put your head in the sand. Now, the first thing the author says that one must do is, I guess, sadly, hit rock bottom, and then from rock bottom have the acceptance of the problem, and that will liberate you and give you the keys to own it and to break free of the shackles of all those parts. Because the author goes on to say here that we need to own it. We need to own all parts of ourselves. We need to own all parts of our lives. And of course, along the way, to start to disown things that don't serve us, that don't help us, which includes people, it includes things, and it includes parts of our past. So the author also goes on to finally say that we shouldn't worry, overly worry, about what other people think, because people are going to think whatever they want to think. You've got no control over what other people think. And to get on with your life, to accept yourself, to accept your problems, and to understand and accept your calling, and to try and live and express that calling as best you possibly can. So that's it. So thank you very much for joining me on this episode of Jim's 5am Club on this beautiful Sydney spring morning. I reckon today's got to be close to perfect. Sad to see that tennis court there not being used on this lovely day. But I'll head off to work now. It's going to be a scorcher. It's going to be hot. So I wish everybody a wonderful Friday, a wonderful last day of the business week, and hope you have a great weekend. So I look forward to coming to you from another place with another message of empowerment, and continue along my path to being one of the most prolific producers, generators of personal development material in the world, where I take book summaries, I take books, I take experiences, and I add the backdrop of Sydney or wherever I am in terms of a walk and talk, and I add my flavour to it as well. My life experiences, because everybody lives a different life. Now, we've all had a different past. We're all going to experience a different present. I am here, you are there, and even if you were here, you would have a different perspective to what I have. And we're all going to live a different future. So make the most of this beautiful gift that we have, our time allotment, our lifetime allotment, and hopefully we can continue to learn, to live, learn, and pass it on, and to enjoy this wonderful place that we live in. I can just look across here, the expanse of the waterways, and I can see canoeists out there, kayakers, I can see boats, I can see the ship probably preparing to leave, and the wonderful worksite down here at Barangaroo. As you can see, this expanse is going to be the Barangaroo Metro Station. There's going to be tennis courts. There's a movie being shot down there. So where those tents are, close to the water, there's a movie being made with Ryan Gosling and Emily Blunt called The Fall Guy. And it's taking the TV series from the 90s, I think it was, The Fall Guy, and they're turning it into a movie. And this will be going on for at least a year or a year and a half. And there's a hive of activity here all the time. Haven't got to see any of the celebrities, but there are lots and lots of people that come and go from this site every day. Anyway, take care. Yasas. Enjoy your day, and we'll chat again soon. Bye for now.